Good evening, everyone. Can we have your attention? Wow, that was really quiet. Good evening and welcome to the 8th annual Loukoumi Foundation Make a Difference Awards. It's good to be back. And thank you to everyone for sticking with us these last 2 years with all these great virtual events. We have our producers through Wall Street Webcasting who have gotten us through all these great events. And tonight is the first event that we are doing that is hybrid. So not only do we have all of you here in New York, but we have people tuning in, not only across the United States, but around the world. We have people in Greece. We have people in Puerto Rico. We have our friends in Gander and Newfoundland, Canada. Out in the West Coast, the middle of the country. And it's just great to be able to unite everyone in one evening like this. Since we were last here in this room 3 years ago, because of all of you, the Loukoumi Foundation has grown to heights even I never thought were imaginable. And we now unite over 100,000 children around the world to do good around the world for good deeds. Thank you. And I'll direct your attention to some slides we have. Also, since we were in this room last time, the Loukoumi Foundation opened the Loukoumi Foundation Treatment Room at St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. And get this, for those of you that don't know, that treatment room is sponsored by all of these kids who donated $1. Yes. And our leader sitting right here, Ava Tsapatsaris, and also the Ann Hutchinson School, who started this program here, we have now collected over 76,000 $1 bills towards this room, and we're pledged 150 over the next 5 years. So thank you to all of you kids. Since we were in this room the last time, the Loukoumi Foundation has also opened the Chef Maria Loy Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation Teaching Kitchen at the Floating Hospital in Long Island City. Our dear, dear friend, Maria Loy, who's done so much for so many people, unfortunately couldn't be with us tonight. But Maria, I know you're watching, and we thank you for that support. And we're going to do great things at the Teaching Kitchen. And the Loukoumi Foundation has pledged $50,000 over the next 5 years to fund that Teaching Kitchen and all its programs. The Loukoumi Foundation also still sponsors its exhibit and its book nook at the Westchester Children's Museum, not far from here in Westchester. We also have been doing wonderful programming with schools. This past year, we started a program called Never Forget Letters. With Come From Away, the Broadway musical. We have Judy Abrams with us, one of the producers of Come From Away, sitting right there. Judy, thank you. And what we do is children write never forget letters for families who lost loved ones on 9/11. And you have to put it in perspective. These kids weren't even born on 9/11, but they're learning about it in their schools. And they're writing these letters to these families. And you know what? These families wrote back to many of these kids, individual letters telling them about the loved ones that they lost and telling them about their stories. And it just was such a wonderful emotional project for kids to participate in. So thank you. This year, the Loukoumi Foundation also sent kindness postcards into space. And with us tonight from Blue Origin Club for the Future is Rosemary Esposito. And on your tables, you will see postcards. These postcards are going to be, they will ride up on a New Shepard rocket, the Jeff Bezos Aerospace Company, Blue Origin. They're going to ride up on a rocket, go up into space, and then come down. And we had our Dallas president, Beckett Potter from Dallas, who gave us this idea. And we said, you know what? Let's do something to spread kindness into the universe. So instead of just writing a postcard to yourself, we're having people write postcards to someone else. So when this postcard goes up into space, it's going to say flown to space. So decorate the front of it, there are crayons on your table, and then on the back, write an address of who you want it to go to. And then just deposit that postcard at our auction table later on in the night, and we will put a stamp on it and we'll make sure that it goes up on the New Shepard rocket. We've also been helping the environment with our wonderful board member, Justin Sather, out in Carlsbad, California. And with his project, the Parallels Project, we have been able to save acres of land in the rainforest in Ecuador simply by collecting, again, $1 donations and writing letters where the Reserva Land Trust will then sponsor the money to help us save these acres of land in the rainforest. The Loukoumi Foundation has also been continuing its Dream Day program, which we'll find out a little bit later. Many of you entered videos into our Dream Day, and we're going to see those. And one of you here tonight will get your Dream Day to come true in the near future. We did our baseball project, and with us tonight is Meredith Kim, the CEO of Pitch-In for Baseball and Softball, and Michael Moran, the development manager. Thank you for being with us. Dean Katsoris started this program, and you'll be hearing a little bit more about it later on in the program. We've worked with the National Bullying Prevention Center on our bullying programming. We work with Three Wishes for Ruby's Residents with our nursing home project with a wonderful young lady, Ruby Kate Chitsey from Arkansas, who's also watching tonight. She has started an incredible nonprofit that helps seniors all around the world, and we've been very honored to work with her to help seniors, especially during the last couple of years. We've also helped with the environment with ECOS, the environmentally friendly cleaning supply company, and we thank them for all that they've done to help us with our environmental projects. And also, since we were in this room last time, three years ago, we published the book that's on your table called Inspiring Stories That Make a Difference. This is a book of all the kids. Take a look at it. There's 75 kids in there who have written essays how they are changing the world one good deed at a time. And we had so many responses that we're doing a second edition next year with Judy with Come From Away. And I hope all of you who have an inspiring story will submit it so that you can have your story told and everyone can see it. Last month, our project was literacy awareness, and we teamed up with the Pajama Program, and we have the founder of the Pajama Program with us here tonight, Genevieve Paturo. Thank you for being here with us, Genevieve. And last but not least, we started our Loukoumi Good Deed of the Month Zooms this past September, and every month we would go to a different school and host it. Many of the schools were we did it at the Ann Hutchinson School, and Annette Keene is here. We did it at many of the Catholic schools, and Linda Doherty here, the Associate Superintendent for Catholic Identity from the New York Archdiocese is here. Thank you. Dr. Robert Glass is here, the Superintendent of Eastchester. Principal Madeline LeBou from the Eastchester Middle School, who's getting an award tonight. Dr. Adam and J.C. Kiernan, the principals of the two Catholic schools we're honoring tonight. Kate Marino representing the Chapel School, and of course, Father Nick Ankdahl with Holy Trinity, where we call Loukoumi our home. You've always said that, and it means a lot to us, so thank you. And before we get on with our program and the awards, we'd like to zoom in to another very special school. Now, those of you that don't know the story of Come From Away is a town in Newfoundland, Canada, called Gander. And on 9/11, over 7,000 airline passengers could not land in the U.S. airspace because it was closed, and they were diverted up to Newfoundland, Canada. So Judy Abrams from Come From Away came to me several years ago and said, the message of kindness in Come From Away is so similar with the Loukoumi Foundation, we have to do something. So that started the Inspiring Stories book that's on your table. But then we also partnered up with a school in Gander, Gander Elementary School, and they have many essays in there, and they now are probably the most vibrant Loukoumi chapter that we have around the world. And we'd like to zoom in so that we can see our friends in Gander. Where are you guys? I know they're there, we got the email, we got the text. Oh, there they are in their school. Welcome, guys. We're so happy that you're there watching it. Thank you, Chris. There you are, Chris. And we look forward to coming up this fall and doing another Loukoumi Good Deed Bus and a whole weekend of activity. So thanks, guys. Enjoy the show. Two last things. We are teaming up with the New York Mets on July 10th for their annual food drive. There are flyers for that on your table. And our silent auction is in the back, and we're actually all virtual this year. So all you have to do is scan the code with your phone, and it'll take you directly to the item. So without further ado, we would like to show you a video about what all of these great kids all around the world have done. You've heard me talk about it, but now we want you to see what these kids have done in great cities around the world. And this video was edited by one of our award winners tonight, Jacob Naclario. So let's take a look at the video screen.
Hello, my name is Athena. I am from Athens, Greece, living in Marathon, and I'm the president of the Loukoumi Foundation in Greece. My journey with Loukoumi began a few months ago when I read this book with so many interesting and inspiring stories of children trying to make a difference. I immediately wanted to be part of the change. Many emails and meetings later, Loukoumi Kids Club Athens chapter was formed, and on October 23rd is going to implement its big first humanitarian action. After thorough research, Loukoumi decided to support the voluntary non-profit organization for the protection of mothers and children Ark of the World. For that purpose, Loukoumi is gathering stationery stuff, food, clothes and medicine by many children, as well as big companies to be donated to the organization. I'm so happy that we're all trying to make a difference in this world, and let's hope that our actions will blossom. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Dimitri Lofetis. I'm from the Hellenic American Academy in Deerfield, Illinois. On Make a Difference Day with Loukoumi, we made winter packages for local foster kids. We also ordered items from the Amazon wish list for the Greek nursing home. We love helping our community. Together, we can make a difference.
During the recent Make a Difference Day, our Loukoumi Dallas chapter met the North Texas Food Bank to deliver non-perishable food supplies for the community. The Dallas chapter donated 391 pounds of food to the North Texas Food Bank, which will make 325 meals.
Wow! We also continue our mission to deliver new toys, books, and art supplies to the kids at Genesis Women's Shelter. We also shared the Postcards to Space project with the kids at Genesis. With our postcards returning to Genesis Women's Shelter, St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital, and Three Wishes for Ruby's Residence.
Finally, we helped clean up a Dallas park by picking up trash. Becca, Zayden, Nico, and I showed the Dallas community that kids really can make a difference with their good deeds.
Cheers to good deeds!
Hi, my name is Arsh.
Hi, my name is Yvonne.
And we're from Dubuque, Iowa. For the Good Deed Day, me and my brother coordinated with Three Wishes for Ruby's Residence and collected items to donate at Stonehill Communities. We also collected handmade cards and raised $220 for St. Jude Research Hospital. Together, we can all make a difference.
Hi, my name is Niall. I'm from Gander, Newfoundland. For Make a Difference Day at Gander Elementary, students visited the Gander and Area Food Bank with a donation of non-perishable food items. We visited Orem Bethesda Manor and Golden Years Estate, where we delivered care packages for seniors. Then we went to Cobbs Pond Rotary Park to display our kindness rocks. Lastly, we went to the Gander Town Hall for a garden cleanup. We had an awesome Make a Difference Day at Gander Elementary.
Hi, my name is Justin. I live in Carlsbad, California. And for Leukemia Make a Difference Day, I'm going to be speaking with the author of Garbage Guts.
And this is what I can do to make the world a better place, is I can write a children's book teaching you, and then you can go out and teach your friends.
And I also did present my project to my class today.
I'm mailing this book to Africa so I can teach my pen pals about plastic pollution.
My name is Rashid Said from Tanzania. I'm team leader of the Parallel Project. We are happy to receive the learning material here in Tanzania to teach the student on how to care about the planet. Here in Tanzania, we have a big problem of the single use of plastic waste because we don't have a recycling center. So this is so great to teach young kids on how to take care of our planet. Together we can change the world.
Hi, I'm Ava Tsapatsaris and I'm on the Loukoumi Kids Club board. Here in New York for Make a Difference with Loukoumi Day, we visited the 9/11 Memorial and St. Nicholas Greek Orthodox Church and National Shrine, where children presented Never Forget letters written by students around the world to families who lost loved ones on 9/11. Since then, many family members have written personal thank you letters to the students, acknowledging how much these Never Forget letters meant to them. In fact, the Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is planning to sponsor an exhibit at the 9/11 Tribute Museum, where children around the world can visit and write their letters in the museum and deposit them in a beautifully decorated mailbox. The museum will then deliver these letters to the families to let them know that we will never forget. On Make a Difference Day, our New York Loukoumi Good Deed bus also visited the floating hospital in Long Island City, where we dedicated the new Chef Maria Loy / Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation teaching kitchen for families. The Floating Hospital was founded in 1866 as one of the first healthcare charities in New York City, dedicated to caring for the sick children of families living in tenement homes. Our teaching kitchen will host families with hands-on education and tools for managing chronic illnesses, maintaining nutritious diets, and developing social and practical life skills. Families served by the hospital are frequently moved from city shelter to shelter with little to no notice. Our team also brought food cooked earlier on in the day on our virtual event with Chef Loy, as well as other food items needed for patients at the hospital and area homeless communities. We also donated beautiful silk scarves to the patients at the hospital. The scarves have been gifted to the Loukoumi Foundation from the estate of Eileen Finkel, a trailblazing designer and manufacturer of scarves for designers like Yves Saint Laurent, Bill Blass, and others. It was a great day. Together, we made a difference.
Thank you for helping my country, Puerto Rico, with the help of those in need.
We are going to share our values.
Thank you, Loukoumi.
Hi, my name is Adriana. For Make a Difference Day here in South Florida, we had a packed day. Our first stop was to drop off food items at SOS Children's Village. Next, we decorated, filled, and dropped off smile sacks to nursing homes and cheered up the residents. Last, we did a beach cleanup in Pompano Beach and collected 5 bags of trash. That's how we made a difference in South Florida.
Hi, my name is Ruby Chitsi. I started a nonprofit organization that provides small wishes for nursing home seniors across America. I loved helping Loukoumi on Make a Difference Day. We made Amazon wish lists and showed kids all around the world how easy it was to help nursing home residents in their area. Together, we can make a big impact on some of the loneliest people across the world.
Let's hear it for all these great kids around the world. Thank you all. And now to proceed with the presentation of tonight's awards, we're doing something very special. It was a great idea that Ava had given me. We are going to have the presenters be our graduating seniors. Many of these kids have been with the Loukoumi Foundation since they were 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, and a lot of them are graduating this year. We wish them well, and we ask them to be presenting our awards tonight. So the first award, I'd like to introduce to you the only recipient of the Loukoumi Superstar Award, Ava Tsapatsaris, who will be attending NYU in the fall.
Thank you, Nick. I'm going to begin with the Courage Award. Conor Dwyer is an incredible 8-year-old boy, a student at the Ann Hutchinson School in East Chester, New York. Conor enjoys riding his bike, swimming, and sled riding. In September 2021, Conor was diagnosed with osteosarcoma, a rare bone cancer in his right leg. And in December, Conor had a partial leg amputation to remove the tumor. While he undergoes chemotherapy at Memorial Sloan Kettering, Conor has valiantly fought through the setbacks that has come his way during the course of his care. Despite all of this, Conor is still a happy guy who loves Legos and being with his family. During his ongoing road to recovery with more treatment and rehabilitation, Conor has shown tremendous courage in battling through his treatment and recovery. When the Loukoumi Foundation learned about Conor, we immediately thought about presenting this inaugural Courage Award to him. Conor will eventually be fitted for a prosthetic leg and hopes to get back to doing everything he loved to do before his diagnosis. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is amazed at Conor's courage and asks everyone in the room tonight to please stand as we proudly present the first Loukoumi Foundation Courage Award to Conor Dwyer. Yes, Conor.
You want to say thank you?
Thank you.
Accepting the irony of him being too nervous to talk when getting a Courage Award. He did want to thank everybody at MSK who have been amazing, and everybody at Ann Hutch who have certainly been supportive, and everybody around. I it's not just the big things for the parents. Frank and Siobhan picking up Casey a couple times from school, that was really a big deal that day. being able to count on everybody around in the community certainly has helped us out, and we're gonna keep asking for things. I have been saying since December 13th that I have seen courage. When a seven-year-old boy took my hand and walked to the hospital to go into a surgery he didn't want to have, but he had to do it. And he didn't fight and he didn't cry and he went and did it. And it would have been a lot easier for me if he did. But that was the definition of courage to me, and I've seen it in my life. And you are a very courageous young boy.
Thank you, Ann Hutch. You've been great. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
To present our next awards, please join us in welcoming a wonderful woman on our Loukoumi Kids Club board, Arietta Xilas.
So the first award is for Rashid Syed. Rashid Syed is a third-year college student studying community development at Arusha, Tanzania. After learning about the high amount of illegal trash dumping in Zanzibar, Rashid joined Zane Goodall's Roots and Shoots nonprofit organization in hopes to see the landscape of, landscape of Zanzibar change for the better. He started a movement to clean up marine areas and plant mangroves to restore vegetation and conserve natural areas. Inspired by another Loukoumi Award winner, Justin Sather, Rashid also joined the Parallel Projects. He worked on providing education to students, reducing plastic waste, and cleaning the Zanzibar beaches. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Rashid Said.
Hello, everyone. My name is Rashid from Zanzibar, Tanzania. I'm the leader of the Parallel Project in Zanzibar. Through the Parallel Project, we have done many activities in bringing about changes in my country and world at large by cooperating with Justin. As you know, in Tanzania and Zanzibar, we have the problem of illegal dumping. So we have conducted many activities so as to bring about changes in my country and world at large. Again, thank you so much, Loukoumi Foundation, for giving me the award in this year. I hope this award will give me motivation in bringing changes in my country and world at large. I'm so proud of the Loukoumi Foundation. I'm so proud of the Parallel Project. Thank you so much.
The next award is for Lara Wills. Lara Wills is the Director of Community Outreach at the Cafe Royal Cultural Foundation, NYC, fostering artistic growth, self-expression, and enriching the lives of young people in the arts through music, performance, visual, and literature. Under Lara's direction from Hamburg, Germany, Cafe Royal Cultural Foundation, NYC, has helped funded over $50,000 in community grants for artist endeavors for children in the five boroughs, working closely with programs such as Art Start, Brooklyn Arts Exchange, and Gibney Dance, to name a few. Laura is currently working on immersive education workshops that address the unique needs of low-income children to augment their social, emotional, and academic needs. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Laura Wills.
Good evening from Hamburg, Germany. I hope everybody's having a great evening so far, and I really wish that I could be there. But I just wanted to say thank you so much to the Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation for this incredible honor. I truly believe that together we can make a big impact in other people's lives, and that's why I'm so thrilled to even be mentioned among all these great kids and adults who are making that difference. Can't wait to be back in New York City soon, meet everybody, and participate in everything that the Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation does. So thank you again so much, and enjoy the rest of your evening. Bye.
Thank you, Arietta. Lucy Caltabiano is a student at Chapel School and was chosen to lead a service learning initiative through the school's SL2 program. She raised $1,011 for the charity Gilda's Club, which is an organization inspired by the actress Gilda Radner that supports patients impacted by cancer. She raised the money by having a pajama day at school and Disney trivia night. Lucy shared the information with students at the Chapel School about Gilda's Club and collected art supplies for the organization. Lucy also dances with the Studio B Dance Center in Eastchester, New York, and serves on its leadership committee. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Lucy Caltabiano. Congratulations. Our next award goes to Arsh Pal. Arsh Pal is a 12-year-old painter from Dubuque, Iowa, This talented artist sells his paintings and donates the proceeds to many different nonprofit organizations, including St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. And he has raised more than $15,000 for various charities. In fact, one of Arsh's original masterpieces is featured this evening in the back of the room as a part of our Loukoumi Silent Auction. And the link to the auction, for those of you watching virtually, is in our chat on your screens. Arsh is a board member on our Loukoumi Kids Club board, as well as the organization Three Wishes for Ruby's Residents, and teaching painting lessons to nursing residents. He is a recipient of many national and international awards, such as the High Flyers 50. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Arsh Pal. Congratulations. Congratulations. Our next award goes to Caitlin Michaels. Caitlin was diagnosed with a rare eye disease at the age of 8 and decided to make her mess into her message. She formed Caitlin's Vision, a non-for-profit organization that helps children with visual impairments. She works to promote children's eye health and to bring awareness to the importance of routine eye care. She raises funds to provide children with assistive devices, eyeglasses, and to help pay medical bills. She also provides a yearly scholarship for students who suffer from an eye disease or who are pursuing a career in ophthalmology. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Caitlin Michaels. Congratulations. Congratulations, Caitlin. Jacob Naclario has been involved in the Loukoumi Foundation since he was in sixth grade and has participated in many initiatives, including park cleanups, supply drives for animal shelters and nursing homes, and donating food to the homeless. When the Loukoumi Foundation started their Kids Club newsletter last year, Jacob wanted to highlight the extraordinary kids through a video newsletter. He believes that through these video newsletters, he can inspire others to take action for a cause that means something to them. Jacob is also a passionate advocate for fundraisers and supporting charities for autism and Huntington's disease. On the academic front, Jacob recently won several awards at the Future Business Leaders of America conference. Next week, he will be graduating Eastchester High School, and he will be attending Villanova University in the fall, where we know he will continue to do great things. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Jacob Naclario. Congratulations.
The next two awards are for Blue Origin Club for the Future and Holy Trinity Goya. Blue Origin was founded by Jeff Bezos with the vision of enabling a future where millions of people are living and working in a space for the benefit of Earth. Founded by Blue Origin in 2019, Club for the Future is a foundation whose mission is to inspire future generations to pursue careers in STEM and build life in space. The club and its collaborators are doing this through their Postcards to Space program, Space Post. Focused curriculum and access to space on Blue Origin's rockets. Last year, Loukoumi Kids Club board member and Dallas native Beckett Potter introduced the Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation to Club for the Future's Postcard to Space program. The Loukoumi program featured sending kindness into the universe as students draw postcards with their dreams of the future, inspirational messages, or words of kindness. These postcards will be launched into space and brought back on a New Shepard rocket. The postcards are then mailed back and stamped to flow into space. The Loukoumi Foundation also encourages children to write the postcard and send it back to someone to brighten their day. On your tables is a postcard for each of you with some crayons. Please each donate a postcard tonight with a kindness saying, write the address you want it to deliver to, and we will take care of the rest, including the stamp. Please drop off your postcard at the auction table before you leave. We want to thank Blue Origin for inspiring us to reach for the stars. And the Loukoumi Foundation, Make a Difference Foundation, Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Blue Origin Club of the Future. The next award is for Holy Trinity Goya. The Holy Trinity Goya, Greek Orthodox Youth of America, in New Rochelle works together each and every year to make a difference in the community and the lives of others around them. The Goyans have cooked meals for the Oasis Shelter in New Rochelle and made sandwiches for Grace's Kitchen in White Plains. The Goyans have also participated in building projects with the Fuller Center, formerly known as Habitat for Humanity, to assist in the construction of homes for those less fortunate. Goyans also assist by volunteering at the church's annual festival and at support of various Loukoumi Foundation's initiatives. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to Goya.
To present the next two awards, please join us in welcoming a member of the Loukoumi Foundation, Lena Janaris, who will be attending Fordham University this fall. Lena.
We will now be presenting the St. Charles School, an award to St. Charles School. St. Charles School in Staten Island prides itself on creating a community of learners that are united under the teachings of the Catholic Church. St. Charles School students become lifelong learners who embody the moral principles and characteristics which empower them to inspire others. This year, St. Charles School conducted a school-wide gift bag and card collection project for two local nursing homes, had many food drives to benefit local communities, and made cards for children at St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital. Students also honored the first responders and essential workers and made thank you cards and had them delivered to the local police stations, firehouses, post offices, hospitals, and their school crossing guards. Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present a 2022 Make a Difference Award to St. Charles School.
Thank you.
We will now be presenting an award to St. Anthony School. St. Anthony School in Nanuet, New York has 127 kids from 3rd to 8th grade. St. Anthony School has had many projects this year and that give back and make a difference. Over $1,000 worth of items were collected for their Ukrainian mission, and over 130 food boxes were made for their Meals on Wheels. St. Anthony's mission for Birthright collected over $1,000 worth of items. Food was donated to St. Peter's Food Pantry, and gift bags were sent to St. Aidan's Ladies Guild for sisters that are infirmed in Rockland County. Monetary donations were also given to the American Cancer Society, One-to-One Learning, and St. Peter's Food Pantry. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is proud to present the 2022 Make a Difference Award to St. Anthony School.
Now I'm welcoming Konstantin Katsoris, who will be graduating from graduated from Fordham Prep, and will be attending Tufts University this fall.
Hi, everybody. The Eastchester Middle School, under the leadership of its Student Leadership Council, Principal Madeline LeBou, and teachers Adam Chertok and Josephine Logan, have numerous charity events that their co-curricular clubs and Student Leadership Council support. For starters, EMS students have raised $430 for the Save the Children Emergency Fund to support Ukrainian children and their families with immediate aid. Students have also raised money for Autism Speaks and the National Alliance on Mental Health. Students and the PTA also run clothing, school supply, and food drives for those in need. Most recently, on May 21st, over 170 middle school and high school students participated in the Relay for Life event benefiting the American Cancer Society and raised over $26,000. The Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation is... Our next award is the inaugural Loukoumi Foundation Baseball and Softball Grant to a community to help refurbish their baseball field. Last year, I started a program with the Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation and the nonprofit Pitchin' for Baseball and Softball. We are happy to welcome with us tonight Meredith Kim, the CEO of Pitchin' for Baseball and Softball, and Development Manager Michael Moran, and I ask them to please join me at the podium. Over the course of the year, the Loukoumi Foundation raised, including a new windscreen, a field liner, field paint, new bases and plugs, and bullpen improvements. Unfortunately, the Powercross youth community cannot be with us today as they had a tragedy with one of the members in their organization, but they prepared a video for us, so.
Hello, my name is Jeff Stormett. I am the co-founder of Powercross Ministries. We want to say thank you to Make a Difference Foundation to help us with our baseball field and field equipment. Just this week alone in our community here in Statesville, North Carolina, we had a young man who grew up in our program that was taken in gun violence. So your donation is going to go a long way, and we really thank you.
Thank you, Constantine. Thank you both so much from Pitching for Baseball for being here.
Before we conclude the awards, I just wanted to invite Ava up one more time. Thank you.
Thank you, Constantine, for the introduction. Nick, I know this is not a part of the schedule this evening, so just hang tight. This year, I was named a Coca-Cola Scholar. I am one of 150 winners selected out of more than 68,000 applicants for this highly competitive college scholarship. Nick has been an amazing role model to me and many other kids around the world, as you can see tonight. Nick and the Loukoumi Foundation will always be a part of my life. In 2019, Nick surprised me with the Loukoumi Award, and now it is my turn to surprise him with an award. Coca-Cola has given me the opportunity to thank one individual who has had a positive impact on me, my educational goals, as well as inspired me to make a difference. I am proud to say for that the 2022 Coca-Cola Educator of Distinction Award, I will be honoring Nick Katsoris. Nick, thank you for being the person that you are. Now it's my turn. It's Nick's Make a Difference Award.
Thank you. Thank you so much, all of you. Thank you, Ava, for even thinking of this. I wrote something in the letters that she asked me to write for letters of recommendation, and I really mean it when I say that someday Ava is capable of taking over this foundation. She and all these kids are the future of the Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation. So thank you all so much, Ava. I'm really touched. Really, thank you so much. How about we watch some Dream Day videos now and make some kids' dream days come true. So as you know, we have the Loukoumi Dream Day program that goes back to 2008. We've had a boy play football with Eli Manning at Giant Stadium. We had a girl dance with Misty Copeland at the American Ballet Theater. Another young lady watched a spaceship land on Mars from Mission Control at NASA. And tonight we're going to make another Dream Day come true. So many kids in this room have submitted videos that we'd like to show you now. And later on tonight, we will make the announcement of who the 2022 Dream Day winner will be. Let's have a look.
Hi, I'm Emily, and I want to be a doctor when I grow up. I want to be a pediatrician because I love helping kids. When I was younger, I had to get surgery on my ears, and it really helps to have a doctor that tries to make things fun. When I grow up, I want to raise money for play centers and to keep kids' minds off their treatments. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Romina from Beacon Ice 10, and my dream is to be a veterinarian scientist because I would like to make medication to help animals around the world.
Hi, my name is Arsh Powell, and I'm 12 years old. I love to paint, and my dream is to meet Chris Ferger, who is a phenomenal painter that lives in Massachusetts. I want to take painting lessons from him because I want to fulfill a wish. and that wish is to provide free painting lessons to kids who have mental and emotional disturbances.
I dream of a day with the ocean. No, not that ocean. The ocean. Ocean Ramsay. Here's why shark conservation is so important. Without sharks, we can't have a healthy ocean. Without a healthy ocean, we can't have a healthy planet. So I want to be just like Ocean Ramsay and save sharks.
When I grow up, I want to be a veterinarian because I love animals and I love helping them. Someday I want to own a animal shelter or an animal hospital. I would like to also work at one before maybe someday I own one. And I have 3 pets and I try to give them the best life possible.
My name is Gianni DeMarco. I go to St. Charles School. I'm 6 years old. When I grow up, I want to be a paleontologist because I like to dig up dinosaur bones.
Hi, my name is Emily Rowe and I live in Newfoundland. When I grow up, I really want to be a vet. I have so many animals and I would really like to know how to help other animals that are in need.
Hi, my name is Lamin Nixedekas. I love drawing, dancing, and of course helping others. When I grow up, I'd like to be a doctor. I'd like to help children in need in the hospital. I did a sock and pajama type drive 2 times, and I plan to do more to help others. Thank you, have a good day.
Hi, I'm Yanni Xerikyash. You may know my sister, Labi Nixerikyash. And I want to help the world too. I want to be an inventor, and I want to invent and stuff to help kids and adults around the world like me. I had to have a surgery. One of my legs was longer than the other. This is how I will help the world. Goodbye.
Let's hear it for those great kids. So at 9 o'clock tonight, we are going to announce the winner of this year's Dream Day contest. So check back with us at 9 o'clock. And now I have the honor of presenting the Loukoumi Make a Difference Foundation Inspiration Award to Mr. Dean Spanos. It's an award we present each year to someone who is a perfect role model for others to follow, someone who serves as an inspiration to all children to make a difference in the world. Dean Alexander Spanos was born in Stockton, California, and from a young age, he always loved football, playing at Lincoln High School, earning varsity letters in football and golf, and later he received Lincoln High School's Hall of Fame Award. Today, Dean Spanos is owner and chairman of the board of the NFL team, the Los Angeles Chargers. Spanos has led the team through numerous franchise records and victories, and his leadership is also present in the National Football League as a member of the NFL's Management Council, Executive Committee, and as chairman of the NFL's Business Ventures Committee. Spanos also serves as president of AG Spanos Companies, and along with his brother Michael, oversees all construction operations nationwide. The Spanos family has a multi-generation commitment to community involvement and is recognized as one of the NFL's most philanthropic families. In 1995, the Spanos family created the Chargers Impact Fund, which has provided nearly $13 million to support a wide range of services and programs directly benefiting children and families. In 1999, Dean Spanos created the foundation's largest ongoing program, Chargers Champions, which has provided nearly $6 million in direct assistance to schools, teachers, and students. The program provides grants to improve fitness, nutrition, and athletic programs on school campuses. Spanos is also known for his generous backing of youth and high school football. And in 2015, he and the Chargers were honored by National Pop Warner with its prestigious NFL Team of the Year Award. And speaking of the team, we have a message of congratulations for Dean Spanos from one of the brightest Charger stars. I direct your attention to the video screens for a message from LA Chargers running back, Austin Eckler.
Dean, what's up, man? Just wanted to say, over the past few years that I've known you, on and off the field, you've always had the support of us as individuals and a team. So it does not surprise me that you are receiving the Inspiration Award. And man, congratulations. You and I both know there's a lot more work to be done, but it's always good to stop and recognize, you know, how far we've come and the good things that have happened of the work that we put in. So once again, congratulations, brother, and we'll see you soon.
Dean Spanos is the recipient of countless awards. In 2006, President George W. Bush appointed Spanos as a Board of Trustees member of the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts. That same year, he was the recipient of the Golden Achievement Award from the Boys and Girls Clubs of San Diego. Most recently, the Spanos family and the Chargers received the Light of Hope Award from the Epilepsy Foundation of San Diego. And tonight, we honor Dean Spanos with our Humanitarian Award, a man who is indeed a role model, a trailblazer, a humanitarian, and an inspiration. Ladies and gentlemen, accepting virtually from the West Coast, please join me in welcoming our 2022 Loukoumi Foundation Inspiration Award honoree, Mr. Dean Spanos.
As my dad became more and more successful, it was, you know, I'm becoming successful because of what the community support I get is. And so I never want to forget the community.
I'm from the post-UCSD and I'm in sixth grade. And
I think he was inspired to help because he knew what it was like to have nothing growing up.
You might think it's a dream, but dreams come true, believe me.
Having an NFL franchise gives you a tremendous platform to help in all different ways that you can imagine.
If you dream of doing something, you can accomplish it.
With this platform, not only did it give him the ability to help and reach out, but he has the players.
We hope this field provides the same opportunities that I had growing up.
It's important for the players to show up because these young kids look at the players and the players are able to say to them, look, I started with nothing. I dreamed about being an NFL player, and here I am today.
And every day you come out here, you got to get better.
If you take the time and you go out in the community, there are a lot of people in need of help from all different perspectives. So anything you can do there and you see progress, because I like to go back and talk with some of the kids, talk to some of the teachers, and they will tell you how it's made and changed their lives. And those are the type of things that you know, to me, you like to see. Thank you and good evening. I wish I could be there tonight in person, but I do want to take this moment to congratulate all the recipients tonight for receiving this incredible award. I want to thank Nick Katsoris and the Foundation Board for honoring me with this special privilege. I'm at a loss for words. It really does mean a lot and it really touches me very closely. You know, I don't know where to begin. I'd like to just say a few things about my father, who was my inspiration. He wrote a book about, 20 years ago called Sharing the Wealth. And the book talks about a lot of different things, but everybody thinks sharing the wealth means sharing money. And that's everything but what the book is all about. It's sharing the wealth of knowledge that he had in being raised during the Depression, he and my mother, becoming successful and sharing how that all happened. And while that all happened, he learned that it was so important to give back to his community. One of the most compelling parts of his life was when he bought the Chargers. It gave him a platform to help not just in Stockton, California, but all around the state of California and the United States and even in the world. It's a great way for us to reach out in a much broader way to help as many people as we can. There's a lot of focus here in Los Angeles with the Boys and Girls Club, so we see that every day. And our players are out there. And I've said this before, the most important thing you can give or anybody can give is their time. Anybody can write a check and that's great. But to go out there and give your time and spend with these kids and to help these kids or whoever it is that may be in need is very gratifying and makes you feel good. And as I've always said, and I know my dad always taught me this, we wouldn't be successful if it wasn't for all the people around us, for our communities. I think one last thought I'd like to leave everybody with is that I know it was so important for my father to instill in me and our family to carry on this legacy and help people when we had the opportunity to help them. And I think I would say to all of you, if you have that opportunity and the means to do it, do it. It's the right thing to do. It does make you feel good. And it, really, at the end of the day, if you help just one life, one person, maybe that person will go on to another person, help them, and then it'll be two, and then it'll be four, and then it'll be eight, kind of create a ripple effect. Who knows? And that's what we need to do in this world today to make it a better world. But you got to start somewheres. But with that, I just want to say thank you again for this great award. It was an honor to be talking to everybody. And I hope to be there next year in person to meet as many of you as I possibly can. Have a great year. Stay healthy. God bless you all.
Thank you, Dean, for being an inspiration. And I know you're watching. I know your family's watching and everyone from the Chargers. We thank you for inspiring so many youth and for doing so much to make a difference. So thank you. Before we conclude, and I know you're all hungry and I know the kids want to dance, there's two quick things that I need to do. I need to thank our sponsors for tonight. Our Loukoumi Good Deeds sponsors, Dean Spanos and the Los Angeles Chargers, Mr. and Mrs. Michael Psaros, and First American Title Insurance Company, Mr. Jeff Mitzner. Our Loukoumi's gift sponsors, Eileen and Gary Franklin, George's Angels, and Jeannie Wrangless. Thank you to all of them and to all of you for supporting our organization. It is only through your support that the Loukoumi Foundation can flourish and do the things that it does, so we thank you. And Ava, you had a surprise award. We have one more surprise award. And you all know and love this person because you've seen her for many years. Jillian, can you please come up to the podium? Jillian Nelson has been taking photos at the Loukoumi Foundation for almost 20 years. And Jillian never charges the Loukoumi Foundation a penny. And she's a lot of times she's coming from other gigs and she always manages to make it here to preserve these memories and all these kids' memories. And we've got so many wonderful memories in our archives, all because of you, Jillian. Yeah, we're taking a selfie. So surprise, Jillian, you get a Loukoumi Make a Difference Award. Listen, thank you everyone for being patient during the program. We hope you enjoyed it. Now let's have some food. We'll announce our dream day at 9 o'clock, and please enjoy the evening.